Psychologists, psychoanalysts in particular, make a great deal of this contrast and consider that the baby's view is inferior to the adult's. And if an adult should acquire that view, in psychoanalysis, this would be called regression. The point that is missed is that the two ways of looking at things need each other to balance out, and that one needs the baby's view as a basis for the adult view, because if you don't have it, you take the adult view too seriously. Get completely carried away by it. And that would be analogous to a person who, in playing poker, loses his nerve because he doesn't realize it's only a game. So he becomes a very bad player. In exactly the same way, we in life are only playing a game. But because we didn't keep the baby view, we can't see it. So what we would call a Buddha view is one that knows both, and therefore is not taken in by the adult games, although perfectly capable of playing them, but insofar as they are not regarded as finally and absolutely serious, he's not captivated by them. Now that's what comes in meditation. Now don't misunderstand me if I say practice in meditation. Don't be in a state of expectation, working day after day to improve your meditation. Meditation doesn't like that. You just do it. But it is true that as time goes on, and you are in that state of silence, you will see this quality of the world. But when you get into the meditation consciousness, you see that nothing is more important than anything else, or less important. There is no way of wasting time. Because what is time for except to be wasted? And you would be, furthermore, you've got you're accustomed now to sitting and doing nothing. I mean, meditation itself is the perfect waste of time. Thank you.